Lamonians, welcome to my class. And by the way, I am teacher Mary Sheila Dungay. My subject is Introduction to the Philosophy of the Human Person. And of course, to those people who are new here, this is my picture. And I will be your subject teacher for this whole semester. And our subject core is Introduction to the Philosophy of the Human Person. So before we are going to our topic today, attention, okay? I have two rules here. Don't you ever forget to bring your, of course, your notebook. It's a very important thing to take down all the important detail while I am explaining. And of course, you're gonna use pen to write every important detail, okay? So are you ready to learn? Because I am ready also. And by the way, okay, so let's read this quote from Socrates. An unexamined life is not worth living. So it's very correct and it's very true. Okay, it's very approved according to Socrates. So for me, you should examine yourself so that you have worth in this living or in this life, okay? So yun. So what do you think is this? Why did he say these things? Okay? So it is because this is his philosophy. This is the philosophy of Socrates. So what is your philosophy? For me, my philosophy in education, okay, I will translate it in Tagalog. Ang edukasyon ay isang kayamanan na hindi mananakaw ng sinuman. So that is my philosophy, of course. So today, before we are going, okay, let's read our objective first. At the end of the lessons, the student will be able to, of course, first know the meaning of philosophy and its importance as a discipline and a means for understanding life. And second one, realize the value of doing philosophy in obtaining a broad perspective of life. Third, construct a philosophical reflections based on concrete situation from a holistic perspective. So that was our objectives for this lesson. Okay, so introduction, doing philosophy. And of course, what is philosophy and what do you think is the meaning of philosophy? Of course, so philosophy comes from two Greek words, philo, meaning to love, and sophia, meaning wisdom, okay? Means love is pagmamahal, and of course, wisdom is what? Karunungan, okay? So original means love of wisdom or pagmamahal sa karunungan. Ayan. So, you know what? It is also defined as the science that by natural light of reason studies the first causes or the highest principle of all things. So, what I said kanina, I given you an example, the philosophy of Socrates and my philosophy. So, did you understand the philosophy? Okay. So, under this definition, meron tayong four things to be considered. Okay, so of course, first is science. The investigation is systematic. When we say systematic, it is what? It is organized, okay? It follows certain steps or it employs certain procedure, okay? That is the under the definition of philosophy. And the second one is the natural light of reason. So, a philosopher uses his natural capacity to think or simply human reason alone or the so-called unaided, okay, reason. So, you know what? Philosophy investigates things not by using any other laboratory instrument or investigative tools, neither on the basis of supernatural revelation or otherwise it becomes theology, okay? So, next is study of all things. So, a philosopher studies human beings, society, religion, language, God, and plans, among other concerns. So, you know what? The distinction between philosophy from other sciences. So, all other sciences concern themselves with a particular object of investigation. So, halimbawa, for example, anthropology study human beings, right? So, in a relation with the society. So, yung mga sociologists study what? Society. It forms structures, and function, right? So, yung mga botanists focus their attention to plants. Linguists limit themselves with language, okay? So, yun. And theologians investigate God. So, yun yung ibig sabihin ng study of all things. And the fourth is first cause or highest principle. So, a principle is that from which something proceed in any manner whatsoever. Okay? So, under this, meron tayong four principle. So, these are principle of identity, principle of contradiction, principle of excluded middle, principle of sufficient reason. So, let's define these four principles. And the first principle is principle of identity. So, it states that each thing is identical with itself. Okay? So, the example is whatever is, and whatever is not. So, everything is what it is. Everything is its own being, and not being is not being. Okay? So, next one, the principle of non-contradiction. It states that something cannot be both true and not true at the same time with dealing with the concept. So, hindi pwedeng magpasabay ang katotohanan at hindi katotohanan sa isang oras. Okay? So, it is impossible for a thing to be and not to be at the same time and at the same respect. Ayan. So, number three, okay, principle of excluded middle. So, can be expressed by the propositional formula P. It means that a statement is either true or false. Okay, so, a thing is either is or is not. Everything must either be or not be, between being and not being. So, there is no middle ground possible. Okay? So, next is number four, principle of sufficient reason. So, nothing exists without a sufficient reason for its being and existence. Of course, everything happens right now, or whatever situation that we are facing today, meron po rason, okay? While we are facing this pandemic, everything has its own reason why God allowed these things, okay? Okay, so that was the principle, the four principle, okay? So, let's go to the branches of philosophy, okay? So, the first branches of philosophy, okay, this is metaphysics. Okay, what do you think is a metaphysic? Okay, it deals with the first principle of things, including abstract concepts such as being, knowing, substance, cause, identity, time, and space. You know what? I will give you an example or the question of philosophy. Okay, or metaphysics rather. So, halimbawa or in Tagalog, it is the example of the question, okay? Anong uri ng mga bagay ang umiiral? Okay, ano ang kalikasan ng mga bagay? Meron bang mga bagay na umiiral kahit hindi naman natin nadarama? Okay? So yun, ano ba ang kahulugan ng pagiging isang tao? Ano ba ang kahulugan ng kamalayan? Meron bang Diyos? Okay, that was the example of question of metaphysics. Okay, and I will give you another example. So, clouds and block of ice, they do not look like water, right? But, they can explain in terms of water. When water evaporates, it becomes a cloud. And when water freezes, it becomes ice. Okay, so as we can go back to our question kanina about metaphysics, okay, ano yung mga uri ng mga bagay na umiiral? Okay, so did you understand the metaphysics? Okay, so I will give you another example of metaphysics. Okay, according to Thales, okay, si Thales ay isa sa mga ama ng pilosopiya or philosophy. So according to him, everything is water. Everything we experience is water reality. So everything else is appearance. So nothing we experience in the physical world with five senses is real. Ayan. So of course, kinakailangan natin gamitin ang five senses so that we can able to experience the reality. Right? Okay. So that is metaphysics. And the second one is, of course, ethics. So, it is generally a study of the nature of moral judgment. Philosophical ethics attempts to provide an account of our fundamental ethical ideas. So, you know what? Ethics also is a branch of philosophy that explores the nature of moral virtue and evaluates human action. So, question, how do we tell good from evil or right from wrong? Okay, yun yung example ng ethics. Or sa Tagalog, yun, magbibigay tayo ng ano, na example sa ethics. Meron bang pagkakaiba ang matuwid at mga immoral na mga gawain? Yan. So, anong mga gawain ang matuwid? Anong pinapahalagahan ang sukdulan o may kaugnay lamang? So, gamit ang mas malawak o mas eksaktong paraan ng pagtatalakay, paano ako dapat mabuhay? So, that was the example of ethics, yung mga tanong na ganyan. Okay? So, how can we determine kung ano yung tama at ano yung mali? Okay? So, yun ang ethics. So, we'll give an example of ethics. Okay? What constitutes a human person, okay, according to Socrates, okay, and how much freedom should we have, or who should we decide, okay, according to Edward Borga Duvoy. So yun mga halimbawa or example ng ethics, okay. So when we say ethics, there is what? Nature of moral judgment, okay, and there is a critical perspective. Okay, so next is, okay, epistemology. So it deals with the nature, sources, limitations, and validity of knowledge. It addresses varied problems, the reliability, extent, and kinds of knowledge, truth, language, science, and scientific knowledge. So, halimbawa, I will give you an example or question in epistemology. Okay, meron nga bang kaalaman? Paano natin nalalaman na may alam tayo? Paano natin malaman na may iba pang nakapag-isip? So yun, it talks about the knowledge. Okay? So yun yung mga halimbawa ng epistemology. So ang epistemology, it explains, okay, how we know what we claim to know. How can we find out what we wish to know? Ayan, how can we differentiate truth from falsehood? So, yan yung halimbawa ng epistemology. Okay, yung mga question na ganyan. Okay. So, next is, okay, logic. So, sa logic tayo. Okay. Comes from the Greek word logic and was coined by Zeno the stoic. So you know what? Si Zeno, is isa sa mga successor ni Aristotle, okay? So he's also a founder of movement known as Stoicism. Ayan. So it means treatise on matters pertaining to human thought. Okay? The study of correct reasoning, especially it is involved the drawing of inferences. When we say logic, of course, there is what? There is argument or study of argument, ang logic. So when we have argument, of course, there is inferences. And after inferences, what? There is conclusion. So, I will give you an example of logic. Okay? So, ito. All spiders have 8 legs. Black widow are a type of spider. So, what do you think is the conclusion of it? Ano yung magiging conclusion mo? Okay, ulitin ko. All spiders have 8 legs. Black widow are a type of spider. So, yun. Ano yung magiging conclusion natin dito? And of course, what? So, the conclusion is, of course, Black Widow have 8 legs, right? So, yun. So, yun yung logic. Kinakailangan ng conclusion, kinakailangan mong makipagtalo kung ano talaga yung totoong reason. Okay? So, yun that is logic. Next is aesthetics. It is a branch of philosophy that deals with the nature of art, beauty, and taste, and with the creation and appreciation of beauty. Okay, so what do you think is the meaning of aesthetic? So when we say aesthetic, okay, there is what? There is appreciation of beauty. Example, okay? The car is beautiful. You are so lovely. You are so beautiful. Okay? That is the meaning of aesthetic. So there is what? Okay? Seeing or there is, okay? Makita mo ang kagandahan ng isang tao. Okay? So yun yung, okay, aesthetics. So under aesthetics, okay, meron importance of aesthetics. So, it vitalizes our knowledge. Okay, it means it make our knowledge of the world alive and useful. So, we know that we go through our days speaking up a principle as fact here and there and to and frequently see how they are related. Okay, so yun. It is the part of a play, a poem, or a story to give us new insight to help us see new relationship between the separated items in our memories. Okay, so that is the meaning of it vitalizes our knowledge. And the second one, it helps us live more deeply and richly. So halimbawa, a work of art, or whether a book, a piece of music, painting, or television, okay, shall help us to rise from purely physical existence into the realm of intellect and the spirit. So, when you have your painting, you will appreciate the beauty of painting kahit ano or hindi mo maintindihan, but you can appreciate that meaning. Okay, you can appreciate the beauty of it. Okay, so yun. So, it brings us in touch with our culture. So, you know what? Things about us change so rapidly today that we forget how much we owe to the past. Okay? So, you know what? Our past is part of our culture, right? So, we keep on thinking and over again, it will happen sa atin, okay? For 1,000 years. So, it is part of our culture. Okay? So, yun yung past natin. So, at least, our past, kahit hindi man maganda or maganda man ito, at least we appreciate it today. Right? Because this is part of our culture. Okay? So, that is aesthetic.
This is the end of our part one. So please stay tuned to our part two because I will post it in LMS. Same page pa din po. And yun lang po, a thank you.